Dan, have you been assured that you'll be coaching this team next season? And if you haven't been, how confident are you that you will be?
At this point in time, I haven't had conversations with Ray Shero about that. About your question about coaching this team next year.
Dan, can you, regular kind of postseason thing, can you talk about any injuries guys are playing through, particularly with Evgeny Malkin and Paul Martin, and what, you know, some of them going to maybe need some procedures or anything in the offseason?
I am, you know, I think the Paul Martin was playing with a significant injury in the last few games. In terms of other players, we had probably a handful of other players with some bumps and bruises and some, you know, injuries that they were certainly playing with, but nothing that would have, you know, would have kept them out of a regular season game even. So in terms of procedures, there's nothing that was pending or needed to be done. And Kenny Malkin, you know, had some bumps and bruises in different spots, and not anything much different than a few of our other guys as well.
Dan, what's the best way to describe your philosophy for how you've used Jerome Iginla after he came over? Obviously, he played on the left wing side most of the time, wasn't on the power play. If he were to return next year, is there a chance that he could get used differently or more the way he was used in Calgary?
You know, you mentioned two areas of the 5-on-5 and where he was played. You know, it was the best fit for our team, and where Jerome was used 5-on-5, and in an effort to get him, you know, on a line with Evgeny Malkin playing that position, the left wing was the best spot for him to be able to be in that position. We moved him to the right wing with Brendan Sutter and the series with the Bruins. We knew when Jerome came in to our team that was going to be the situation with Jerome and playing him on the left side, playing him in different, you know, trying to get him with different people in different combinations, but we did know that coming in, and that's how he was used. In terms of the power play, you know, Jerome was used. He was on the power play as a defenseman in the Islander series. He was used as a defenseman for part of the series against the Senators, and then as a forward position, and in his position on the power play, the last series was as a, you know, in the forward unit, not back on the point. So we moved him around in different spots. The Islanders here for different reasons. The shot against the Islanders, it wasn't a part of the effectiveness of our unit against the Senators for their various reasons. So we moved him to a forward position, and you know, we're pretty comfortable, obviously, with the results we got in with our power play in the Islander series as the Ottawa series, but obviously not getting the goals and the results in the Boston series.
Dan, I was wondering if you could share what you view the definition of franchise goalie. And then this question, is Marc-Andre Fleury still that guy in your mind?
I think you're Marc-Andre Fleury. I'm not sure the definition of franchise goalie. And it's he's our number one goalie. He's a number one goalie for this franchise, and he will be going forward. So, you know, we were in a situation where Tomas Vokoun went into net and won the third and fourth games of a series for us and continue to play in our net. But, you know, Marc-Andre Fleury is a guy who's going to come back to our team, and he's going to be the number one goalie. He's going to be our franchise goalie. He's going to be this franchise's goalie.
Dennis, just to follow up on the power play a little bit. I know after the Ottawa series, you talked at great length about how you liked your power play depth and the different looks that you could throw out there at people. If things weren't going great, you could shake it up a little bit and have a first unit that looked a little bit different. But you kept going back to 58 and 71 at the points and then with Sid and Kunitz and Neil. Can you tell us why you did that when you had the other options available, or was Martin's injury a bigger deal in that regard than maybe we knew?
A little bit to the latter, but not significantly. I mean, it was a little bit of the case. We really felt like in the power plays in each of the games, we were only didn't have those guys together for at least half the time in those games. You know, and whether it was guys were tired and we had to mix up the units, or we had guys in the penalty box. Those are some of the reasons why we didn't have those guys all together for all those power plays, bless you. And so we felt like we hadn't gotten the main unit, the top unit, together enough versus we need to make a change. We had enough significant change with the different personnel because of those situations that we didn't get there enough, we felt. So we kind of felt like we had too many options and too many different looks, not the looks we wanted with the top unit as much as we wanted.